And I believe that holding a new election, once the war starts to wind down, would give Israelis an opportunity to express their vision for the post-war future.
Chuck Schumer is the highest ranking Jewish elected official here in America, a staunch supporter of Israel. What's your response?
I think what he said is totally inappropriate.
Disagree, but that wouldn't be the first time I have a disagreement with Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, who is absolutely furious with the fact that Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer decided to give a Senate speech on the Senate floor just last week, calling for Israel to hold elections as soon as the war in Gaza is over in order to oust Netanyahu. Schumer also said that Netanyahu is an obstacle for peace, which is absolutely correct, considering Netanyahu himself propped up and funded Hamas, the very group that he's now at war with. Now, here's more of Bibi's defiant response to Dan Abash.
It's inappropriate for to go to a sister democracy and try to replace the elected leadership there. That's something that Israel, the Israeli public, does on its own, and we're not a banana republic. I think the only government that we should be working on to bring down now is the terrorist tyranny in Gaza, the Hamas tyranny that murdered over 1,000 Israelis, including some dozens of Americans, and is holding Americans and Israelis hostage. That's what we should be focused on. And as far as what Senator Schumer said, the majority of Israelis support our governments. 82% of Americans support Israel instead of Hamas, but the majority of Israelis support the policies that we're leading. If Senator Schumer opposes these policies, he's not opposing me, he's opposing the people of Israel.
So I have some polling. We're gonna break it down and talk about where public opinion is in regard to this war, both here in the United States and in Israel. Unfortunately, public opinion in Israel is overwhelmingly in favor of the war on Gaza, which will not keep them safe, in my opinion, in the long term. We'll get to that in just a moment. But Cenk, any thoughts on what Netanyahu said in that very testy interview?
Yeah, a lot. A lot of mainstream media don't give you honest news. We do, you know why? Because of you. Paid membership on YouTube makes all the difference. Hit the join button below and you become the hero that sustains us. So number one, Chuck Schumer's speech was a watershed moment. It was historic. Leadership in the Democratic and Republican parties have never broken with Israel, ever, no matter what they did. And the fact that the majority leader in the Senate and the most senior Jewish leader in Congress broke with Israel is literally unprecedented, never happened in my lifetime. So that is a giant shot across the bow to Netanyahu and more importantly to the people of Israel, saying you gotta get rid of this guy. Like, this is way too much, it's hurting Israel, it's hurting Jews across the world. I think Schumer's absolutely right. When it comes to Netanyahu, he says, oh, we're not a banana republic, you can't tell us what to do. Yeah, you're right, no problem, give us the $4 billion back.
Yeah, money has strings attached.
Yeah,
money
that's how
has
it works.
Strings attached. So if you don't like criticism from US politicians and the American people in regard to how you're carrying out this war, or in regard to your existence as a leader of Israel, then stop taking the money.
Yeah, that's it, easy. You can prove your independence, you don't need us at all, God bless. By the way, Israel does pretty well. They have universal healthcare, they have paid family leave, a bunch of things we don't have.
Right.
So you're right, you don't need us, good luck. Good luck to you.
Cenk, okay? I heard from politicians in Israel that Israel is not another star on the American flag.
Okay, fantastic.
Prove
by
it.
The way, they're debating whether to give Israel $14 billion right now in the House. So let's just stop that debate. He doesn't want it apparently, no problem. But you can't say, give me $14 billion, I demand it. You must give it to me, give me $4 billion every single year, I demand it. And I'm not gonna listen to a goddamn word you said. That's not how it works, okay? And by the way, give us Iron Dome back too. What else would we like back? So nonsense. You take money from us, you have to at least listen to us a little bit. You should listen to us completely, but you don't. So we should stop giving you the money. All right, now you see all the tricks he threw in that short little segment. 62% of Americans prefer Israel to Hamas. to Hamas, which is a terrorist group.
Yeah,
wow. Congratulations, yeah. Wow, you must be so proud. So no, the reality is the overwhelming majority of Americans want a ceasefire. 80% of Democratic voters want a ceasefire. Netanyahu is 100% against a ceasefire. Netanyahu is also 100% against a Palestinian state. And the great majority of Americans, the great majority of Democratic voters want a two-state solution, which right. Netanyahu is blocking.
But let's get back to the actual question at hand. Okay, Dana Bash didn't ask Benjamin Netanyahu how the American people feel about the war on Gaza or how the Israeli people feel about the war on Gaza. Dana Bash asked about Chuck Schumer demanding that Israel hold elections to oust a deeply unpopular prime minister by the name of Benjamin Netanyahu. So Benjamin Netanyahu, why don't you talk about public opinion in regard to your leadership in Israel? He doesn't want to address that, right? So deflect, 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 deflect. This is, you know, I'm going to talk about public opinion on this, public opinion on that. Let's talk about public opinion on you. Your own people can't stand you, okay? And Netanyahu has managed to remain in power during this war by convincing Israelis that it makes all the sense in the world for him to remain in power as long as the war is ongoing. So he has an interest in prolonging the war because he wants to hold on to power. He wants the power so badly. Chuck Schumer was 1,000% correct, and Netanyahu absolutely is an obstacle for peace in the Middle East and is hellbent on dragging the United States into a hot war with Iran. That is what's currently happening. That is the state of the situation right now.
Yeah, when he said, you know, he doesn't have a problem with me, he has a problem with the people of Israel.
No.
That's not remotely true.
Nope.
And so right now is, you know, you're going to see the polls are against Netanyahu. If he were to call an election today, he would lose. That is why he's not calling an election. And the most important part, guys, is everyone, not only here but in Israel, thinks when the war is over, we're going to have to do an election and have a referendum on not just Netanyahu but his radical right-wing government. And I don't know which way that's going to go because a million things are going to happen between here and then. And the Israeli people, I feel like, are still in kind of a blind rage, thinking that the Palestinians are Nazis or something, which is insanity, insanity, right? So I'm not rose-colored glasses about it. But the problem here is that Netanyahu is incentivized to never end the war, because once he ends the war, they're going to have an election. And right now, as things stand, he would lose. So that means, for his own self-interest, he's never, ever going to end this war.
So to Dana Bash's credit, she did keep asking him the same question that he was trying to avoid answering over and over again. For instance, she pointed out to him that polls show that the Israeli people are growing more and more angry with Netanyahu's governing coalition. So let's watch that moment.
You're talking about support for the idea of toppling Hamas. That makes perfect sense. There were other polls in Israel, three major Israeli television stations that said what Israelis also support are early elections. That's what I really want to focus on here is Senator Schumer not calling to sort of topple the government, but specifically says when the war winds down, will you commit to calling new elections? That's my question, will you?
Dana, two-thirds, first of all, what you said is wrong. The vast majority of Israelis oppose early elections until the war doesn't end. We've just had many polls on that. Look, a lot of the polls are twisted.
Channel 12
polls
says,
are guided by
Channel 12
all sorts of
says 64% of Israelis support
but
early
all polls
elections.
Show that's not. No, I'm afraid that they asked them the question, do you support it during the war? And they said no.
But that's not what Schumer is calling for. He's calling for new elections when the war winds down.
Listen, I get how rough it is to accept the fact that the majority of your own people can't stand you. And he did try his best to twist her words and avoid answering the question. So Dana Bash tried one more time, which Bibi didn't like.
Our victory is your victory. We're fighting these barbarians that are not
to
merely
new
threatening the survival of
when
Israel,
the war
but
winds
threatening
down.
Everything that we hold dear together.
Will you commit to new elections when
I
the war
I think that's
winds
something
down?
For the Israeli public to decide. But it's not something. No, look, that's something for the Israeli people to decide. I think it's ridiculous to talk about it. It's like after 9/11, you know. After 9/11, you're in the midst of fighting the war against Al Qaeda, and an Israeli would say, you know what we need now. is either new elections in the US, or if your system doesn't allow, then President Bush should resign and we should have an alternative leader. You don't do that.
Well, let's
you don't
talk
do
about
that to
why.
A sister democracy to an ally.
If Israelis were calling on George W. Bush to step down after he failed to keep the American people safe during the worst terrorist attack in American history, I would agree with the Israeli citizens arguing that.
Yeah, so there's two parts that's misleading to that. By the way, the French and many other countries did warn us, and they did it as friends, not as enemies. And they said, don't go into Iraq, that's a terrible idea. So as an ally, they were trying to help us by saying, you're going in the wrong direction, and they were right. The second part that's misleading is, Israel has a parliamentary system, not the kind of presidential system that we have. We can't call early elections, Israel can. So can the UK and other parliamentary systems. So he's purposely trying to deceive you there. And did you notice the Freudian slip? He said, until the war doesn't end.
Yeah, okay. No, I totally noticed that, because he doesn't want the war to end, which this guy, I mean, has no problem with all of the pain, suffering, slaughter that he is overseeing and pushing for in Gaza, which does nothing to help Israelis in the long term who are concerned about their safety. If you're concerned about your safety, there's currently a Hamas manufacturing plant within your own government, and Netanyahu is the leader of that. But I just want to give you this number, because it's really important. There was a poll conducted by the Israeli Democracy Institute, and they found only 15%. Let me say that again. Only 15% of Israelis want Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu to stay in office after the war on Hamas in Gaza ends. He knows that. He doesn't want to accept it. He doesn't want to answer any questions about it. But Chuck Schumer was correct. He knows Chuck Schumer was correct. And Netanyahu is fully aware of the mass protests that have taken place in Israel against him. He is definitely aware that only 15% of Israelis would want him to remain in power after the war is over. He just doesn't want to accept reality verbally during this interview, and he's probably not used to getting any semi-challenging questions asked of him.
Yeah, so I'm gonna end on a couple of things here. One is a terrific quote by Rabbi Rachel Timmerer, who is Chuck Schumer's rabbi at his temple. And I think she's absolutely right here. Let's go to graphic 8. I think that he said out loud, referring to Schumer, what the overwhelming majority of American Jews are saying to each other, which is that Bibi Netanyahu is making the world less safe for Jews and making Israel less safe for Israelis. Netanyahu himself has said that he completely opposes a two-state solution, and so he is an obstacle to peace. So yes, I think what Senator Schumer said was brave and right. And I saw her speech after October 7th, I saw her talking now, and I think she's terrific. That's what a real rabbi is supposed to say and do, and look out for her flock, as well as all Jews across the world, as well as all humans across the world. So I just loved what she said, and she's absolutely right. A poll, according to Institute for Social Policy and Understanding, just this February, and probably larger numbers now. Actually, the American Jewish community are more likely to favor a ceasefire, 50%, rather than oppose one, 34%. So when you see people on TV talking about how they represent the Israeli people or even Jewish Americans here, they're not telling you the truth. The reality is that Jewish Americans also want a ceasefire, and Israelis want Netanyahu gone. So get past Netanyahu and the right-wing Israeli propaganda machine and see it for what it really is. We desperately need an election in Israel so that Israel can go in a different direction and actually get the peace, because going for endless war is just gonna result in both sides getting killed endlessly.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.